So here is now our first problem for the analysis of statically determinate truss using the method of section. The requirement on this truss is to determine the force acting on member AB, DE, and BD. We have some simple steps to follow in order to solve for the problem. The first step is to check the determinacy of the truss. The second step is to solve the support reactions. The third step is to pass cutting plane at the location of the desired truss member force. For the fourth step, that is to replace the severe truss member with the force. Then for the fifth step, we will make use of the equation of static equilibrium to solve for the unknown member forces. We begin with step 1. We check the determinacy of the truss. We will count the number of members, joints, and reactions component. 7 members all in all, 5 joints, and 3 support reactions components. We know that for a hinge support that is at point D, we have 2 components reaction, that is Rx and Ry, so that is equal to 2, and for the roller support that is equal to 1. If we now substitute M plus R that is equal to 10, and for twice of J that is also equal to 10. So M plus R is equal to twice of J, therefore the truss is statically determinate and externally stable. We can remember that if the truss is externally unstable, there's no need to continue the calculation. Possible solution is to make the truss externally stable by providing properly arranged support reactions that will keep the truss in equilibrium. If the truss is externally stable and statically determinate, just like in our case, we will continue the calculation. We can make use of the equations of static equilibrium to solve for the support reactions together with the member forces of the given truss. If the truss is statically indeterminate, equations of static equilibrium were not enough to solve for the problem. We need additional equations that usually derive from truss deflections. We perform the analysis later on after studying truss deflections. So we will now continue. We solve the support reactions. We label the support reactions to its proper directions, if it is possible. But if it is not, then we just assume the direction. So I assume that dy is upward, dx is rightward, and ax is also a rightward support reaction. If after we perform the operation and the result is negative, then assume direction was incorrect. We will apply equation of static equilibrium, summation forces along vertical is equal to 0. Our assumption is upward forces are positive. As we can see, dy is upward, so that's positive. 60 kN is downward, and 30 kN is also downward, so those are negative forces. From this equation, we can observe that dy is positive, 60 is negative, together with the 30 kN. From this equation, we can also solve for dy, and the value is equal to 90 kN. Since this is positive, assume direction was correct, 90 kN is acting upward. Then we will apply summation moment at point D is equal to 0. Our assumption here is clockwise moment are positive. So at point D, guys, we know that 60 kN with the moment arm of 3 meters will rotate in a clockwise direction with respect to point D. So that is a positive moment. The 30 kN with the moment arm of 6 meters will create a clockwise moment with respect to point D also. So that is also a positive moment. So from summation moment at D, 60 times 3 is positive, 30 times 6 is positive. And for AX, it will create a counterclockwise moment with respect to point D. The moment arm is 2 meters, that is negative. Since that is counterclockwise moment, our assumption is clockwise moment are positive. So from this equation, we can be able to solve for AX, and that is equal to 180 kN. Since that is positive, therefore our assumption was correct, AX is acting to the right, or a rightward support reaction at point A. We'll apply summation moment at point A in order to solve for the value of dx, we know that the 60 kilonewton load with the moment arm of 3 meters will rotate in a clockwise direction with respect to point A, and the 30 kilonewton load at point C with the moment arm of 6 meters will also rotate in a clockwise direction with respect to point A. So therefore, those are positive moments. For dx, that is also a clockwise moment with respect to point A, and the moment arm is equal to 2 meters. So as we can observe, to the equation, all are positive because those are clockwise moment. Our assumption is clockwise moment are positive. So from this equation, we can be able to solve for dx, and that is equal to negative 180 kilonewton. Since 180 kilonewton came out to be negative, that's the sign that is negative, so our assumed direction was incorrect. Dx should be acting leftward or to the left, not to the right. That is opposite of what we assumed. Here are now the correct directions of the support reactions at point D and A of the truss. So 180 is to the left, 180 to the right, then 90, that is upward. We will pass cutting plane at the location of the desired truss member force. Since DE, BD, and AB are unknown, we will pass cutting plane that will cut all those members. We will now draw the free body diagram considering the portion of truss acted upon by least number of unknowns. So as we can observe, the right part of the cutting plane will be acted upon by least number of forces compared to the right part or the left part of the cutting plane. So the reason why we will make use of this right part of the cutting plane as our free body diagram. So here is now our free body diagram. Originally, we have three unknown member forces, that is BD, DE, together with AB. But since BD is inclined, then therefore we have to resolve the horizontal and vertical component of that member force. Okay, so we will now apply equations of static equilibrium to solve for the unknown member forces. We will now solve for member force AB and DE by applying summation moment at point B and at point D respectively on the truss shown. So here is our free body diagram. If we apply summation moment at point B, the only unknown is DE because BD and AB will intersect at joint B, our moment center. So those member forces will not create moment with respect to point B. If we apply summation moment at point D, the only unknown is AB, since BD and DE will intersect at joint D. So that is the technique in solving the problem. You will select the joint where two member forces will intersect. So we will now apply summation moment at point B. Our assumption is clockwise moment positive. So with respect to point B, we have 30 kilonewton. The moment arm is 3 meters. So with respect to point B, that is clockwise moment. Then we have DE. With respect to point B, that is a counterclockwise moment. So 30 multiplied by 3 is positive, and DE multiplied by 2 meters, that is a counterclockwise moment. DE, the moment arm, is 2 meters, that is counterclockwise. And from this equation, we can be able to solve for DE, and that is equal to 45 kilonewton. So since 45 kilonewton came out to be positive, our assumption that DE is under tension was correct. DE is acting away the free body diagram. So DE is under tension. Then we will apply summation moment at D at this time in order to solve for member force AB. Here is our equation, summation moment at point D, clockwise moment positive. So with respect to point D, we have 30 kilonewton. The moment arm is 3 plus 3, that is 6. So here is the value of the moment, since that is a clockwise moment with respect to point D, 60 kN, the moment arm is 3.0 meters, that is also a clockwise moment with respect to point D. Then we have AB, the moment arm is 2 meters, that is also a clockwise moment with respect to point D. So if we try to investigate the equation, so we have positive 60 times 3, positive 30 times 6, then positive AB times 2. So from this equation, we can be able to solve for the value of AB, and that is equal to 180 kN. 180 kN came out to be negative. So since that is negative, our assumption that AB is under tension will be incorrect. So after solving for member force AB and DE, we can now solve for the member force BD. But since BD is an inclined member force, we have to resolve its vertical and horizontal component. So that is BDY and BDX. Here is now our reference triangle to solve for the vertical and the horizontal component of member force BD. For the vertical component, that is just equal to the vertical component divided by the hypotenuse of the triangle, that is square root of 3 squared plus 2 squared, or that is square root of 13. If we perform the operation, we can find that that is equal to 0.55 of BD. Then the horizontal component of BD, that is BDX, is equal to the horizontal dimension divided by the hypotenuse of the triangle, so that is 3 divided by square root of 13. If we perform the operation, that is equal to 0.832 of BD. So this triangle is taken from the given dimension of the truss. So this is equal to 2 meters, and this distance is equal to 3 meters. So 3 meters, then 2 meters. We can apply summation forces along x is equal to 0. Here is our free body diagram. So here is our free body diagram. We apply summation forces along x is equal to 0. We have DE, that is to the left, AB, that is also to the left. But since AB came out to be negative when we solved, that is equal to negative 180, it should be acting to the right. So if we assume that rightward forces are positive and applying summation forces along x is equal to 0, AB should be positive on the equation. So BDX is to the left, so that is also negative. So we can apply AB, that is positive, that is what we are talking about, but AB should be under compression, so it should act toward the free body diagram. Then DE, that is negative, together with BDX. We substitute the value of AB and DE on the equation, so we know that AB is equal to 180, then DE is equal to 45. Then the value of horizontal component of BD, that is equal to 0.832 of BD. From this equation, the only unknown is equal to BD. So we can solve for the value of BD, that is equal to 162.3 kN. Since BD came out to be positive, that is equal to 162.3 kN, our assumption that BD is acting away the free body diagram, or that is under tension, was correct. Here is now the summary of what we have solved. We have member force DE that is acting away the joint that is under tension. And for member force DE acting away the joint, that is also tension. And for member force AB acting toward the joint, that is under compression. To those who wants a copy of this file in PDF, like and subscribe. Comment down below your email and I will send it to you. Thank you.